Well, hey guys, my name is Zahkman, also known as Isaac Buchert, and I live my life as a church audio tech, and I wanted to try to share that with you guys. And part of that is doing things like soldering cables and using products. I'm going to do reviews as well. But today I want to show you how to solder a TRS cable using a Neutrik connector. And, you know, I love soldering. I actually find it one of the fun things in my job. I love to have a day where I can just solder cables and do that kind of work. It feels almost relaxing or even almost meditative. And so maybe you will begin to enjoy that as well. It's also very handy. You can make your own connections. You can do installations in a much more efficient way. You can make adapters. There's quite a few benefits to being able to solder cables, so it's a good skill for you to have. And you know, I make my videos about the church audio life when I have a chance to, because it's a very busy life. And if you are a church audio tech of any sort, I think you'll understand that. And so I also do this when I have jobs already to do. So I have to solder this rack mount snake and get all the connections to it, and we've already ran cables through the room. So I just want to terminate them now. So that's what I'm going to do in this video. So first I want to talk through the different things you will need. They are all shown here. First of all, you need a decent soldering iron with a fairly narrow tip. You'll need rosin core solder. Some kind of clamp is always good. Needle nose pliers are always handy. Some kind of small cutters. Jacket removers are very handy. And wire strippers are essential. And then, of course, your Neutrik connector. Okay, so we want to do a TRS cable, because that's how I'm going to put the outputs of this board into the speakers that are up in the rafters. And so the obvious thing is to start by getting your connector ready. This is actually a connector we've already had from a previous project, so that's why it's not in a package. But I'll just take this apart. And this is a Neutrik TRS connection. So the TRS means tip, ring, and sleeve. And what that means is it's actually going to be a balanced cable. That means it's going to be able to reject interference and hum and those kinds of things. And it's going to be able to be sent a lot further distance without getting those kind of sounds into your sound. So the main parts that are part of that, there is the boot, strain relief, connector, and basically metal sleeve or jacket. I'm not sure what they call this, but the outside. So I also have my cable ready. This is the cable that I need that's going to attach to this mixer. So the first thing you want to do is just put your boot over top of that. And then you want to put your strain relief. The reason why you want to do this first is that there's no way to get that on once it's soldered. So if you forget to do this before you start your soldering, you're going to be in a lot of trouble later. You have to unsolder the whole thing, put it on, and then redo it again. And I think anybody who's done soldering has probably done that at least 300 or 400 times. So best to learn this early and not have to make that mistake. This could be put on after the fact because there's a split in it, but I just put it on now so I don't forget and it's in place. Next thing I do is I put the connector into the clamp just to get that ready to go. So at my church, we always use a Neutrik connectors because they are just really solidly made. They make the whole process simpler so you can solder faster, which makes your time more efficient. And they seem to last for years and years and years. So they're worth the investment. They can be bought on Amazon or B&H Photo or on avshop.ca if you're in Canada. And so I'd say they're well worth getting. Okay, so now that we got the boot on, strain relief on, what I want to do is prepare the cable. So I'm going to use this jacket stripper that we have. And what I want to do is strip back about, some people say it would be your thumbnail length of cable, of jacket off of the wire, maybe a tiny bit more. And this is a simple device. You just literally pinch around it, let it have its own tightness, do one spin around, undo it, and pull the jacket off. It's a really beautiful and easy way to get the jacket off. And be sure don't spin around too often or have it too tight, otherwise you could cut into the actual wires. Once I have this open, I get rid of this little bit of twine that's in there when they manufacture it. Then I want to get these all separated out. There's a bit of foil around the two connectors. Let's just get rid of that. There we go. Now, in this cabling, there's always going to be three wires. And that's what actually makes these a balanced cable, like I mentioned earlier. And while we'll reduce interference or hum, those kinds of things over long distances. And that means they're going to have a ground, a positive, and a negative. And that usually would go on to pins 1, 2, and 3. And to connect to a TRS cable, you need to cut these to very specific lengths. So there's a picture from Neutrik, the exact lengths. Sometimes you don't need to go quite that far, and it may be hard to actually measure that exactly. What I like to do is to line it up on the jack, and considering that my black cable is going to be my longest, I realize I probably made these longer than I need to, so I'm going to trim this one back about there. The white one, then, just doing this kind of visually, considering how much is going to inside of the connector. So let's go, that's there, that's about there. There we go. Okay. About there. Well, that's good, yep. Tiny bit more off of this one. And then the shield. Okay. A little bit less. Okay. So then once those are the right length, then you want to strip back the rubber on there, so we have a wire stripper for that. This, I know, is 20 gauge cable, so you want to use the 20 gauge hole in this thing. You want to strip back just enough to fit into the cups, and no more, because you want the rubber to go right up to that point so you don't have exposed wire. That's about the right amount. And when you're using the stripper, make sure that you get these other ones out of the way, otherwise you might damage them. There we go. Once these are stripped, you want to tin them. And tinning is simply having solder be absorbed into the different threads of the wire. And what you basically do is you need to heat up your soldering iron, which is turned on, and then hold the solder against the wire and have the solder come through it. So I'll show you how that works. So this could be put back into your clamp. One thing to note is that heat travels through the solder. And so one thing that's always good to do is just dab a little bit of solder onto there before you even start. Hold the soldering gun underneath the wire you want to tin, and then push the solder on, and it goes, sucks right in. Hopefully you can see that it goes right into the wire. I'll do that for all three. This gets it ready to solder, and it also holds all the strands together. And you don't want too big of a gloop on there, just enough to kind of cover them well. At this point too, you would tin the connector. And basically this means is filling up the cups that are on there. And one thing I was taught, and I think it's the right method, and I believe you get a better solder, is called, you want a hot solder, not a cold solder. I've looked at other videos online, and they just basically almost like melt the solder by just kind of dripping it into the cups. But what works a lot better is if you actually, again, have solder on the tip of your soldering iron, hold it underneath the cup, and then have the cup get hot enough to melt the solder. That way they're at the same temperature and they bond together much better and create a much better and longer lasting solder. So these already are tinned, but I'll just add a bit more just so you can see an example of that. So I'm just gonna do this one for the ground and hold this on the bottom of it. And then I'm gonna put the solder in. And you see how it melts on. And that adds solder to it, and that is gonna have a really nice solder. The top one's a little harder to get the soldering iron underneath, so in this case I'll do more just to the side. But again, I'm not touching the soldering iron directly to the iron, but to the metal. There we go. And then simply what you need to do is connect the wires to the connector. And for TRS, it's a bit more tricky than other cables. I've just found in my experience that I like to put in the hot cable first. And on a TRS, this should be noted that the tip is always positive, which is actually in the middle. The ring is always negative, which is usually on the top. And the ground is on the bottom. So I can just tell by this, I've actually left a little bit too much exposed. So I'm just going to trim just a little bit off the end on the number two here. And what I want to do is, actually, I just find it easier to start actually with the tip, number two. Otherwise, they get in each other's way too much. And so I'll do that one first. Then I usually do the ground next. And you want to make sure you let that, hold that in place until the solder totally cools. And then what's important is for this last one, make sure that you have it bent right before you even start. Otherwise you're gonna have nothing but trouble here. In this case, it's hard, again, hard to touch underneath it, so I touch more to the side so that the metal heats up. Good. So I still want to avoid that cold solder, but I do sometimes have to tap it just on the end just to make sure everything sits in place nicely. So that's effectively soldered. Now basically take this out of the clamp. Take the strain relief, and it actually has a very natural way that it fits in. You see it kind of slots over that space. Take the metal sleeve, or jacket, whatever, put it through there. Put the boot on the end and screw it together. So that screws on good and tight. You get a nice good connection there. Everything is good and solid, and that is ready to go. If you had a single cable, wasn't part of this kind of installation, then you would now do the other end, it'd be the exact same procedure, and this cable would be done. So hope that's helped you, hope that'll help you do things in the future if you ever want to solder a TRS cable together. If you like this video, please press the like button or subscribe. I'm going to have more videos like this. Also going to have videos where like real life reviews of products we've actually tested out and used in the church, and I will share the good, bad, ugly about those products. And hopefully that'll help you in your purchasing decisions. All right, well, thank you for watching, and God bless.